Hello and welcome to the channel. Today I've got a short but very useful video for you today. And the goal of this is to filter out internal emails by using trigger conditions on the Outlook trigger. Let's go. So let's talk a little bit about this content. So trigger conditions filter events at source. So what that means is they filter out the events before it even actually reaches the flow itself. And so what this allows you to do is to avoid unnecessary runs, because if you bring a full message in to your flow and then you do say a condition or use like the filter action, you're still going to encounter a run, even though you're going to take that message and basically throw it away because you're not interested in that scenario. And so what we want to focus on today is we've got a use case where we receive emails into a centralized inbox. Some of those emails could be from internal associates. Others are going to be from external customers. We want to only process the emails from external customers through this flow. And for the emails that we receive from internal associates, well, we're not interested in them. So we might as well discard them at source and avoid those unnecessary flow runs. Simplify our flow maintenance, because if you ever have to go through your run history, you're going to be looking for like a needle in the haystack if it's like, oh no, internal, oh, external, great, internal. So we can just get rid of them and they won't even show up in our run history. And how we're going to go ahead and achieve this is by using what's called a trigger condition. And this allows us to take our traditional flow expressions, but put them right up into the trigger itself, and we can then address more complex requirements like the one that we just talked about.
Serverless Notes is a community resource that covers best practices, tips, and latest announcements built on contributions by technology enthusiasts and collated from various resources. This resource is structured as first-hand reference material for anybody working with Azure Serverless integration. You can go ahead and subscribe to newsletters and browse serverless tips. The Serverless Notes community is brought to you by Serverless 360, a portal focused on operations and support for Microsoft Azure Serverless resources. It provides exceptional tooling that is not available in the Azure portal and is an alternative to custom-built solutions. You can find more at serverless360.com.
For those of you that may not be familiar with trigger conditions, you do access them by clicking on the ellipsis, those three little dots in the upper right-hand corner of your trigger. And then what you can do is scroll down to the bottom of that dialog and look for trigger conditions. And what you can do then is just click on the add button and then insert your condition. Now, you do know that these are the same conditions that you use elsewhere in your flow, whether it be in a compose box or in any sort of action or condition, but you can then copy those right into this user experience. Now, you do want to ensure that when you are doing that, you do include an at symbol and then your expression when you go ahead and run it. And so this gives you the ability to then run that condition basically within the trigger. Now, how this is going to work is that the condition must be a Boolean, must have a Boolean output. So it's either going to be true or if it's going to be false. So if a condition is true, then the flow will pick up that message and process it. If that expression evaluates to false, that message will get ignored. So that's a very important distinction. Now, there's no better way to describe this than to go through a demo. And so that's what we're going to go ahead and do right now. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's kick these emails off, and then we will go ahead and take a look at the flow and the design. So this is an email that's going to be sent from my Hotmail account, and I've got a subject of external email. So let's go ahead and click send. And then we've got another email, and this is going to be an internal email sent from the same account that we're going to be pulling emails from. And as a result, we're going to include a subject that includes internal email. So let's go ahead and hit send there. So let's just head over to our flow, and I've got a flow created here called tips filter out email. So let's go ahead and click on edit. And here our trigger is going to look normal. It's going to look very much like you would expect any other trigger to look like. One exception is we're not going to filter anything related to the subject or from the from. Like, those are two options for simpler use cases where things are very static. And I would encourage you to use those if you can. In our case, we can't do any sort of conditions that checks like the mail domain that sent the email. And so as a result, that's not going to work for us. We've got a compose shape, and this is more of just for our demo, just to prove when we do receive an email that does get processed through here, that we can then just put the from email address, and those should always be email addresses that do not belong to our same domain. Now, where do we find trigger conditions? As I mentioned, the ellipsis, click on that, and then click on settings. And then scroll down, and then here, what we're going to find is our trigger condition. And this is going to be really the combination of two expressions. The first one, we're going to just go ahead and see if our from field, from our trigger, contains our mail domain. And in this case, this is just a personal domain I have, 2206labs.onmicrosoft.com. You will want to replace this value with your own domain. And so this would be like at, and then whatever your company name is. So go ahead and do that. Now, recall that the trigger condition will only fire when the value of your output is set to true. So in this case, we don't want this to be the case. Like if the inbound email is from a sender in my domain, that's the opposite of what I want to do. So as a result, I'm going to include another expression that is called not, and it's basically going to take the inverse of this value and then flip it. So for example, when I send an email from Hotmail, does it contain this? So the answer is going to be false. But I want it to equal true so that my flow will then actually process that message. And by including the not expression, it's going to flip that from a false to a true. Similarly, if I do receive an internal email, this contains condition is going to resolve to true, but that's not the scenario where I want to process that message. So the not will flip that true to a false. So this is kind of just your typical logic that you deal with in any sort of programming experience. As I mentioned before, do include the at sign because that is required here. Now, a tip that I would suggest is go ahead and figure out and test your expressions outside of your trigger. There's no like way here to do IntelliSense or anything like that. So I would suggest, you know, mess around in a compose shape where you can bring up the expression editor, take advantage of IntelliSense, and then have your emails come in here and then just debug and make sure you're getting the right output that you want. Then go ahead, copy that expression, paste it up into your trigger condition, add an at sign, and then you should be good to go because you've already done that testing. All right, so let's go ahead, let's see where we're at from our run history. So we can see 3 minutes ago we did receive an email. But do note, you saw me, I sent two emails, but only one has shown up here. And so what this should mean is that our process is working. So let's go ahead, let's click on run history. And then let's take a look at our compose action. And sure enough, it was our external email that was processed that was sent from our Hotmail account. And even if we go ahead and find our subject, here it is, external email. And so that is a very simple but powerful example of how you can use conditions inside of your trigger in order to address more complex scenarios. And the benefit of it, as I've mentioned before, is you keep those discarded events outside of your actual flows. As a result, your run history becomes cleaner and we don't process irrelevant emails that don't match our criteria. Thanks for checking out today's video. If you haven't already done so, I would invite you to go ahead and follow me on Twitter. Obviously, you're on my YouTube channel right now, and I certainly appreciate you stopping by and checking out this video. If you haven't gone ahead and subscribed, I would encourage you to do so. Also, if you like this video, I would really appreciate the like as well. So take care, and we'll see you next time on the channel. Thanks.